Gibraltar, the greatest siege in British history. Written by Roy and Lesley Adkins. Read by John Telfer. Prologue. Disaster. After 3 years of relentless siege, everyone on Gibraltar was starving, war-weary, and desperate for the relief convoy to arrive, not realizing that it was yet to sail on the 1,500-mile journey. The convoy was still at Spithead between the Isle of Wight and Portsmouth, though with the newspapers in England full of stories about an imminent assault on the rock, fears were growing that it was already too late to save Gibraltar. Even so, urgent preparations were being carried out on board a multitude of vessels, including the Royal Navy's greatest wooden warship, HMS Royal George, a formidable three-decker with more than 100 cannons and a crew of around 850 seamen, officers, and marines. On board this particular warship, the final consignment of stores needed to be loaded, as well as some last-minute repairs done, but being a fine morning, the vessel would soon be ready to sail. In nearby South Sea, a woman glanced out towards the Royal George, taking in the idyllic scene, before starting on a letter to a distant relative. "The day is calm and pleasant," she wrote, "and as I sit at the open window, the great vessel in the offing, betwixt me and the fair island, Isle of Wight, seems to sway not a handbreadth, nor to flutter a single pennant." Her shock, as she looked out to sea once more, was betrayed by the shaky handwriting. "A dreadful thing has happened. When I had written that beginning of my letter, Dorothy, I looked again southward. The sea was waveless as before, and the fair island sparkled in the sun, but betwixt us and it I saw no trace of the great three-decker. I thought my brain had gone wrong, and rang the bell for Agnes, but when she too could see nothing of her, a terrible apprehension took hold of me, and when the alarm guns from the fort, South Sea Castle, began to thunder, I knew the vessel had gone down. I hear near 1,000 men were aboard of her." In the time taken to write a few sentences with a quill pen, the Royal George had sunk so rapidly that hundreds of people were trapped and drowned. Men in nearby ships were equally stunned. One eyewitness related that they all rushed on deck. What an altered scene in a few short moments! She was not in the spot she so lately occupied. No vestige of her was to be seen. But as soon as the commotion of the water was stilled, for some minutes...
Sample complete. Ready to continue?